Oh, hi kids, it's me again, Gordon. Today, we're gonna make a whole world in a box. And it comes with a mermaid and a diver. It's really cool. All you need is some materials and some tools. What you're gonna need is... So kids, once you finish collecting all the materials, you can start cutting out all the images from the printouts, using your scissors of course. So once you finish cutting out all the pieces from the printouts, we're ready to start decorating our seascape. So what you still need is you need your box. You can use a normal shoebox or any box you can find around the home. And you also need a piece of wax paper. So your normal shoebox and your wax paper. So now what you need to do with your shoebox, you have to make a hole in the top of the shoebox. You can do that using your scissors. Ask an adult or an older brother or sister to help you out with this part. This is to allow light in so that there's light inside the box. Then what we need to do is we need to make a viewing hole for you to look through the side of the box. You can also do that with your scissors. This is a dangerous part and you might want to ask an adult to help you. So once you've made the hole in the roof of the box and in the side of the box, we can start decorating. This is quite an easy part. You just take your glue stick and you place glue at the bottom of the box. And then you take the base of the ocean and you stick it to the bottom of the box. And the light end for this yellow type green be in the front of your box, where the hole is. Place glue at the bottom of the box. Then you take the base of the ocean and then you stick it to the bottom of the box. If your box is too small, cut the page to size so that it can fit inside the box. But the base of my box is slightly larger, so it fits nicely into the base of the box. Then I put the side walls into the box, and it's the same thing. If they're too big, then you just cut them a little bit smaller. Then you have your sky, which you can use to stick at the back of your box. Now, you just place some glue on the sky. If the box is too narrow, you can always cut it a little bit smaller. And in our case, the sky is too high, which is fine. All we have to do is fold it over and glue it down on the back like that. And that's fine. You can also just cut it off, but I find when you fold it over, it makes a nicer edge. Now we have to make the waves inside the box. And what you do is the big waves go in at the back and the small waves go in at the front. So then you lay the waves in their different sizes along the box. Now what you can do, you just fold the waves over on your box like this and make sure you get the right sizing. You just have to glue them to the base of the box. Then you place glue on the sides like this. Then you glue the waves inside the box. now we need to make a sushi roll. Well, it's just what we call it, a Pritt roll. You just take this blank piece of paper and you roll it into a tight straw. We use this to make our images slightly more 3D. You just roll it into a tight roll. And then you glue it down. And then your sushi roll's finished. Then, what you do is you cut it into small discs. And then, we are ready to start decorating the sky in our box. So we'll take our sun and one sushi roll, and we'll glue a sushi roll to the sun, and then we'll glue the back of the sushi roll to the back of the box. And then you'll see the sun will stand slightly off from the back of the box, which gives it a slight 3D look. And then we can do the same with the clouds in the background. So after sticking the waves in and the clouds, we're ready to start sticking our sea creatures in. And we do that by sticking them together, the fronts and the backs. Stick your seahorse together. And you stick your starfish together. And you just have to leave around about a centimeter at the bottom free, so that you can open the flaps, which you can stick to the base of the aquarium. So once you finish sticking your sea animals together, you just have to stick the bases and decorate your seascape. And you place them here between the waves. And you can do this however you like. Now you just have to finish the lid. Remember, cut the hole in the roof of the lid. Have our wax paper now. All we have to do is stick the wax paper to the inside of the lip. Cut this wax paper to be the same size, so it should fit in perfectly. And you glue inside. You must be sure to use enough glue that the wax paper sticks properly all the way around the inside of the box. And that's it. And then you have the roof of your aquarium. And then you place the lid on top of your aquarium. Like this. And then you look through the looking hole to see what's inside. I hope you had fun today making this really cool project with me. I hope to see you again at Pritt soon. Bye.